We're probably still in the very early innings of this phenomenon. I do agree that Disney and Netflix are going to be, you know, among the potential long-term winners. But I think what's important to realize is that, you know, there's probably going to be a shakeout over the next few years as we see more consolidation and as more and more formidable companies like Apple and et cetera jump into the fray.
Disney is going to be measured, for better or worse, fair or unfair, against Netflix. How do you think they'll do?
I think they'll do just fine. Look, I think over the next several years, it's quite conceivable that Disney will quickly, you know, get to, you know, 5 million and potentially tens of millions of subscribers over the next several years. I mean, look at the content that they've already, you know, announced, as Julia alluded to. The one thing that will determine how quickly they jump out of the gate and we'll be watching very closely is the pricing of this service, which we expect be anywhere from $6 to $8 below Netflix and potentially with the pricing power to increase over time.
Julia?
Well, Tuna, I think it's really interesting that we're looking at Disney to come in less than Netflix, as Bob Iger has said, but in that $6 to $8 range, just at a time when we've seen price hikes from Netflix and also just today from YouTube TV raising the price of their skinny bundle to $50 as the skinny bundle gets a little fatter. So I'm curious, though, you know, the ultimate question is how many services will people really subscribe to? Some analysts say it's three services. Others say it's six services. So I think it's there's still a lot of unknowns about how many people can really sustain. But, you know, if you look at Apple TV Plus launching this fall and then you're going to have AT&T Time Warner service, will people really have five or six services or is that too many?
Well, Julia, I would go as far as to say that the appetite for these kind of offerings are right now insatiable. You know, you see the content investments, and we're talking about really quality content here. So to the extent that companies continue to invest aggressively, and don't forget the pay TV bundle, it has been at risk for quite some time now. So you're seeing that secular trend continue, and we expect it has several much more runway ahead.